keep morale within our sights, but we have one important entity under our sleeve, and that is SCP-999. The L5 Command has granted assurance that all personnel within Site-19 will be appropriated with their assigned psychiatric. Nesne resse entestitu tarafende saklande. Chika group letre zureter buhide gozitjar. Komuta, bo yi elisiktien nato ili lisrian bu inselete azalita jatan emin ulo. We continue to face peril threats from various degrees. We must resort to these unwanted attentions and ensure the normalcy of our society. Remember, what we do is what we must. We are the ARC. Reality is somewhat a distortion. How we create a concept or picture it is an interest of our scientific understanding when the subject converses around parallel realities, dimensions, and universes. For every choice we make, we create an instance of ourselves in millions, if not infinite, ways. This is a concept that is relatively more discussed in the multiverse theory, but we are not here to discuss the alternate realities within the RPC universe. Instead, we're going to discuss and compare a universe where the RPC authority is different. A dark, cold, and inflexible reality that shares some commonality, but differently than our own. The SCP Foundation. You know, when I originally made that video when I was supposed to discuss and compare the SCP Foundation and the RPC Authority as an April Fool's joke, a lot of people seemed to be or were disappointed that I actually didn't do it. And so, after a Twitter feed to post, a poll to show, and results to confront, I decided to seriously do it. Not just the fact that I swore to myself that I will never mention SCP in this channel, despite the fact that I did so as an April Fool's joke, and a few-minded people believed that the video should have been made to allow differentiation between the two collaborative websites. Which makes sense, since actual comparison in practicality sense is almost non-existent, and when or if there is a video that does actual comparison, there is often at times bias within the information itself. Then again, bias is almost impossible to be avoided and would occur within this video, but I will try to remain impartial as I can. Don't get me wrong, I love both sites and both have problems of their own, but I won't be discussing any internal politics between the two, just comparison between their lores and other areas of interest. However, comparing these two is at best almost and if not impossible to do so, but I'll explain this bit at the end of the video. With all of that being stated, let's start this video. The SCP Foundation and the RPC Authority are an intergovernmental organization tasked with maintaining normalcy of society by researching and containing paranormal entities and objects known as anomalies. Hence the motto for SCP is Secure, Contain, Protect, whilst RPC's motto is Research, Protection, and Containment. Now while both mottos have some similarities in terms of their overall meaning, such as their goals, RPC is a slightly different case. RPC's motto for Research, Protection, and Containment, aside from describing the goals as an organization, also refers to their divisions, the Research Division, the Protection Division, and the Containment Division. Aside from mottos, both organizations are led by a collective council in charge of their respective organization and management. The Foundation is led by the O5 Command, consisting of 13 people or possibly more since seat numbering varies and it is often believed to be 13 in total. There is another individual who often at times may be considered part of the O5 Command, and that is the Administrator. According to the Foundation database, the Administrator is supposedly an official above, or as mentioned, part of the O5 that is the founder of the SCP Foundation. They are portrayed as an official with level 6 clearance that outranks the O5 members, but this information appears to be subjective. On the other hand, the RPC Authority is led by the Global Directorate, officially consisting of 12 people in total that are referred to as Global Directors. So, both collective councils are almost similar and carry out identical responsibilities. However, what differentiates both the O5 Command and the Global Directorate is the people within those seats. The O5 Command consists of individuals that often at times possess anomalous properties. Some head a department such as the Ethics Committee, or are in charge of a specific project that's under the purview of an O5 member, but it would vary from time to time. For the directorate, this is the opposite. A global director does not have any anonymous properties and are individuals elected to that seat. While they serve only for 2 years, their terms are unlimited and can be re-elected on a continuous base. Thus, many of the GDs usually remain in their seats for years until they retire, resign, died, or have lost to a more persuasive candidate. Each of the GDs have a role in their seats, such as representing a region or a division. In this case, 9 out of the 12 people are GD representatives for a region, such as North America, South America, Western Europe, Eastern Europe, Africa, Eurasia, Asia, Oceania, and Antarctica. For the other 3, they are divisional leadership consisting of the scholar, the commander, and the architect, which I briefly explained more in the divisions of the authority. Both the RPC Authority and the SCP Foundation maintain international relations with nations and other intergovernmental organizations like the United Nations. Now, okay, comparison-wise, it's very different. The SCP Foundation's relations are a bit ambiguous. According to their database, they are entrusted by major national governments. Meaning, if this is true, why are they rivaling against an organization like the United Nations Global Occult Coalition, which is a United Nations component? It doesn't really make sense if you factor in the fact that their policy is the destruction of anomalies, which is super reckless considering that the potentiality of an SCP being destroyed by the UN GOC may cause it to be more dangerous. We've seen this from time to time, such as SCP-1609. And again, if they are entrusted by major national governments, why isn't the SCP Foundation arguing their case to the United Nations Security Council? Now, you may argue that it is just politics, but it's more than just the political affairs that we're talking about here. We are talking about the sanctity of humanity, and more importantly, the ethical and moral implications of a reckless organization like the UN GOC if they somehow attempted to destroy an SCP which would in all probability cause an end of the world scenario. That risk alone should not be taken into consideration. So yes, the geopolitical sphere and the international relations with the SCP Foundation is ambiguous as hell, and as always, varies from person to person. What about the RPC Authority? Well, it is much more cooperative than the SCP Foundation. Much like their counterpart with the UN GOC, the RPC universe has the UNAAC, the United Nations Anomalous Activities Committee. Unlike the UN GOC, the UNAAC is more of a diplomatic and forum assembly discussing and enforcing international treaties concerning the paranormal world. What makes them a bit more different, aside the fact they are both components of the United Nations system, is that the UNAAC is more cautious and reasonable in its decision making. One such example is their continuous support for the authority in times of need and treaty creations such as the Brussels Convention. Another thing to point out about the UNAAC is that they previously attempted to create their own version of the RPC Authority and essentially become the Authority themselves. Of course, this was unsuccessful, but there are a few who still believe that the Authority should be integrated as a UNAAC component or simply take over the responsibilities. So, the UNAAC and the UN GOC have some similarities, but both can't be exactly compared due to both having different approaches. The UN GOC approaches at the destructive aspect, while the UNAAC approaches the peaceful and reasonable solutions like any United Nations component would actually do. Okay, so budgets are not exactly my kind of cup of tea when it comes to topics like these, but there is a huge distinction between the RPC and the SCP's finances. We know the SCP Foundation is much stronger than the RPC due to their unquestionable level of authority within their universe, but of course, large-scale operations worldwide cost money, and according to some, the SCP Foundation has unlimited amounts of money. Supposedly. It is not entirely or exactly confirmed to be the case since, again, whoever you ask concerning the Foundation's budget will vary. For the RPC Authority, it is quite the opposite. They get a huge sum of income as part of their fiscal budget, but the budget cuts occur every time when this economic situation does not look good. Most of their income are often selling anomalies that are safe and do not possess any potential risk of danger or exploitation through commerce. They of course also get international aid and support from the UNAAC, the IMF, and other nations whenever appropriate. One more thing to distinguish between the Foundation is that the budgetary allocation is strictly regulated and projects, left and right, get funded or shut down. What is there to take in after stating these points? A lot of things, but there's one other point that I wanted to discuss at the very end of the video. You may also notice throughout the video, when I was briefly explaining some things about the SCP, is that I've been using some words like it varies, believed to be, often, and so forth. Remember what I said earlier that comparing between SCP and RPC is almost and if not impossible? Because it is. Without explaining too much why that's the case, I'll just summarize it in one word alone. Non-canon. You see, what I didn't mention from the start of this video is that the RPC Authority has a primary canon, meaning everything posted on the main list or attributed to it is all canon. Sure, the RPC has a non-canon section, but come on, who uses it? This is the very reason what differs heavily between the RPC and SCP communities. It's not their structure, history, relations, or overall approach to anomalies, it's their non-canon policy. Anything mentioned in the SCP Foundation is heavily subjective, interpretable, and more importantly, to one's own headcanon. For example, I can state in my own personal opinion that SCPs like SCP-3000 or 035 canonically do not exist in my headcanon. And thus, by that logical approach, I can also consider that the O5 Council doesn't actually exist. It's a phantom group that was created by the administrator, who is in truth the actual person leading the SCP Foundation. But again, this is just an example. I'm not saying this sets a bad precedent, it's just that when you allow such interpretation to take place, ambiguity becomes the norm. Sure, it makes sense for the SCP site since it allows it to remain a secret as part of immersion or whatnot, but such ambiguity creates misinformation to those who are new to the SCP Foundation. Much like videos that create SCP animations, youngsters and interested-minded people may assume these things to be what SCP Foundation is. But then again, whenever has a channel like Infographics ever been run? So yes, the biggest thing to conclude the differences between SCP and RPC is that the lore, the canon, and between these two collaborative sites are incomparable and cannot be treated as the same.